you. Thank you and morning to everyone. So I'm going to tell you the story of a serious and important task, digital transformation at supply chain in SNAM. It's a journey that we have done in the last 3 years, so during the pandemic issue and all the let me say bad experience that we have had in the last years. And in order to do this, I will share with you some key elements that we have used in our approach, because I'm convinced that is useful for any, let me say, any company that wants to improve the value chain and support the growth of the supply chain. Before starting on this topic, I want to introduce and talk you a bit of SNAM, my company, because one of key elements, I think it's also the company and the purpose driven of your company that should allow to do what we have done. And we want to start from a word that is particularly, let me say, crucial in the last weeks, because we discovered that we can do almost nothing without this. I'm talking about energy. Energy is a word that is in our DNA of SNAM. And it's always really difficult to define in a complete way, to give a definition of energy. But what really matters for us since the beginning of the story of SNAM is the impact that energy should have on the lives of people.
Attraverso.
This is why, because...
Progresso. Invest.
Okay, we jump. Technical problem is normal. I just want to say that energy is important and is a part of the DNA of SNAM, because SNAM is a leader in the transportation, storage and regasification of gas. Our story started more than 8 years ago. The company was founded in 1941. And we start the gasification of the country in Italy. I want to jump directly to the last 3 years because it's very linked to the digital transformation of supply chain, because in the last 3 years SNAM decided to not to act only as a leader in the core business, so the storage, transportation and regasification, but also to take a primary place in order to support the ecological and energy transition. This obviously change, and we will see later on how, change also the targets and the environment in which supply chain has been brought to act. The company is in a very good health. If we see the some key figures, we can say that last year we closed with a net profit of 1.2 billion euro, and all the figures are really positive. On the here you can see the dimension, so the magnitude of the natural gas core business activity. That is quite relevant not only at Europe level but also at world level. And this is what I'm saying before. So SNAM in the last 3 years decided to repositioning the businesses and start with these five different companies. We invest a lot in hydrogen, through the bio hydrogen that has not only has also the purpose to study, to analyze how we can improve the usage of hydrogen and the business case linked to the hydrogen. We have SNAM for mobility, for a sustainable mobility, SNAM for environment, for biomethane, the production of biomethane and distribution of biomethane, Renovit linked to the smart efficiency of building, And then Arbolia, that has the aim, has been created, is a no-profit company created to push on the green areas, and we have the target to plant more than 3 million trees in the next years. So we jump to the digital transformation at SNAM. First key elements, digital transformation in supply chain, at supply chain, from my point of view, has not been possible if it's not part of a more, it's a wider project of digital transformation. This is the case of SNAM, because the company decided to invest €500 million in 5 years with more than 50 different projects in order to digitalize and give a different value to the data in all the crucial point, touch point of our grid and our company. Part of this game is also the supply chain. We made a journey, and I show you if it works. Okay, I want to start with the last one of the last sentence. We take care of people and partner. This is another key element. We wanna, thanks to the technology, we wanna enable processes to be more effective, efficient, and so on. But mostly, we wanna evolve people mindset. I have heard before that technology it's not anymore, let me say, a problem, because you can find the right technology for evolution, but work on the people mindset of inside the supply chain, it's really crucial. And we always joke, because we want to pass from a value to pay, because you are a cost for your company, to pay for value that you generate. This period, last 3 years, teach us that in the period when you have, let me say, if you set the right trend, of digital transformation. This is a new opportunity for procurement people and supply chain people to take a new position in the business, take a new level of standing in order to support the business and boost the business of our company. And we think that also inclusion and sustainability are two main topics that in all the company, most of the company talk about these two topics, but supply chain should act and should do more. This is our journey. I don't want to touch all the single achievement that you have already also seen in the videos, but I want to underline that another key element is that we want to evolve our tools landscape. We adopt many of the new technologies that should help and should be normal to adopt in a digital transformation journey. But we have done this for a buyer experience optimization. So we want to increase the engagement of our people. And we want to do that, and we have done that, involve people from the different part of the company, so from requisitioners and from supply chain people, in order to build up this project, because they have to fill them their project. So. We can change and we can use digital transformation also as a lever in order to be more attractive as a supply chain. Because if we use digital transformation to reduce all the routine tasks and shift the position of the people, talented people, also to other tasks that are more creative and more interesting. We can also stand up the level of the competence and also of the talent that we can earn in our supply chain. And this is the only way, I think, in order to say that supply chain change its role and be a real business partner for the rest of the company. Sustain the sustainability. Another part of digital transformation is to focus the technology that are given on the market in order to create an environment in which we can help supplier and also people of supply chain to have a better knowledge on the sustainability and also to improve their consciousness on how deep and how high should be the impact of their action on the both side. Most of our suppliers are PMI, so are not big company, and we really trust that we have to bring them to a certain level of knowledge of all the topics in the ESG environment in order to really have an impact on the carbon neutrality that we want to achieve within 2040. So also in this case, like for the digital transformation, we are thinking and designing a tool that should help to calculate the impact of each single action made together on one side from supply chain, so how you run a tender, how you manage the supply, and on the other end from supplier point of view on how big should be my portion of impact to in order to reduce my emission and overall the emission of SNAM. This is a synthesis of what I've said, what I've seen about the approach. So we are doing another, let me say, journey that put together how we can habilitate this collaboration thanks to tools and digital approach, and what we can do together with our supplier, giving them training and support to improve their positioning and their also knowledge, but on the other end to study together which should be the real lever that they can put on the table and we can evaluate in order to have an impact on our, unfortunately it's not visible, but on our scope 3 target dedicated to the supply chain and dedicated to the supplier that is quite important within 2030. I have finished.
I've got quite a few questions coming in, but let's go straight to the floor if anybody wants to get us kicked off. Excellent, over here.
Can I just talk to you offline after? We're in very similar industries, so I'd be quite interested to find out a little bit more detail, if that's okay.
Okay.
That's the purpose of this event, exactly that. Anybody else before I go online? Okay. Please think some up. I want to know, can you give me an idea of your international footprint? I know that it is international, I know you're a very big company, but what is your spread? What countries are you in? Where do you focus?
We are present in different countries. The internationalization of SNAM started 2000 after the quotation at the stock exchange, more or less. We are present now in with the participation in different companies in Greece, Austria, mostly in Europe, but we have also started to have a representation also in India, in China, and US.
Cool. Given you have such a focus on decarbonization and also on switching to becoming a major European player, what are you? Are you doing anything in direct response to the Ukraine crisis?
Ukraine crisis for sure is another crisis on which supply chain has to work on. We are helping or we are in the front line to help Italian government and also European community to set up possible new way for the supply of gas. So we are working a lot on this. But from my point of view, and taking back to the digital transformation at supply chain, it's an incredible opportunity that we have because without this transition and this journey, also the possibility to change the target and start to think about not normal job, but have a new targets due to the fact that unfortunately we have a terrible situation not so far from us. It's also depending on how flexible are people and the landscape in which you are able to work.
So your roadmap for sort of holding clients' hands and leading them through a transformation for the decarbonization of their supply chain, that was a really interesting slide, especially from my perspective. Do you do that also with technologies in terms of like the platforms that are now coming about? Do you offer a platform as well for your clients?
Not clients, but suppliers.
Okay.
yes, we are. We work with our most of our achievement, and so the platform that we design and implement has been always created. Looking at the, let me say, both sides. So how we improve the user experience of suppliers and how we improve the user experience of buyers. We have done this and we have also reduced many, let me say, throughput time in a crucial touch point of our end-to-end supply chain. Mm-hmm. So the answer is yes, and it's not a matter of giving the opportunity, it's giving a platform, but build up the platform together. Mm-hmm. We have done in a different way, and the result is on the is live.
Sure. It struck me the timelines that you had up there. How long before COVID were you sort of scheduling out the move to robotic process automation? Is this something I can't tell? Was it significantly sped up when COVID hit, or was this something that was going to happen exactly as it happened? I don't think it can quite yet, but I'll read out what I see. Oh no, there we go.
This one.
Perfect.
Okay. First of all, just a joke, but it's not a joke. This photo is where we are March 2020. Mm-hmm. So we sign, we have a lot of paper. Okay. This is our journey, as I said before. So for sure, COVID, when start COVID, and we have to push a lot on the dematerialization. So first step is dematerialization. But then we understood how powerful was this journey, and we designed all the other steps that you can see here. So we passed through automation of several processes. We introduce artificial intelligence and machine learning in order to reduce and to give more compliance in a specific process like the validation of the documentation produced by the supplier during the tender. Mm-hmm. And the next step will be the creation of a virtual assistant to reduce the time frame of specific process based on the new platform that we have implemented.
Excellent. Do we have any more questions coming in from the floor? No worries. I have. I want to understand who are your suppliers and your partners. Like, can you give me a persona of the kind of companies that you're talking about?
I didn't catch the.
I guess what I mean is, like, who are your suppliers? Are they smaller companies? Are they big partners?
We have the landscape of our suppliers are fragmented because we have very huge suppliers.
Yeah.
And then we have a lot of we call PMI, so medium and little company. Also, often focused on a specific area of Italy. So, looking at this landscape, we said before, we have in mind that if we want to have a real transition to a carbon neutrality, it's not a matter of giving a target to the supplier, but it's to build together this journey. And also teach, and more than teach, train and support this supplier to grow up on these topics.
So as I understand it then, let's say, do you have like a head of Calabria or something like that? And then that person will get to know and then hold by the hand all the suppliers within that state, from the small to the big, and so they're participating in the process.
Yes, they participate because we are going to set up a different workshop based on a specific filière, so ICT, then more construction, and so on, in order to share ideas and let me say solutions or potential solutions in order to have an impact and measure this impact on both sides, for Snam and for the supplier.
And would you say this is almost a model for you guys to be more resilient in the future? Not that you were not resilient before, but having these relationships and having the visibility.
But yes, you have a deep visibility. Mm-hmm. And also, we are convinced that if you are on the table, at the same table, and so you are you invest time and resource with your suppliers, I think that the answer will be higher and higher.
Fantastic.
And also the time frame should be short.
Excellent. Well, Does anybody have anything else from the floor? We've had lots coming in online. Guido, thank you so much.
Thank you to you.
Cheers. That was excellent. Thank you.